Shanti, I wanted to ask you about not just practicing at home by oneself, but how one can apply yoga in everyday life.
Yes. So that is real yoga, is to apply in everyday life. What is yoga? Yoga is to nurture our body, nurture our senses, nurture our mind, and nurture our soul. I put that in the Facebook. Our first primary goal is to nurture our spiritual self. Then to nurture our spiritual self, you do nothing. You need money. So you have to be in the business, you know, doing everything you need. So first thing you need is the body. So make your body healthy. Doing yoga position, breathing, everything on daily basis. And then for survival, you need the money. So your career, making money, all these are important, and balancing all these three. So how do you balance it? Set the priority. First priority is our spiritual life. Because spiritual life, if you nurture it, you can be happy, even if you are not very healthy. Even if you don't have a lot of money, you can be happy. If you nurture your spirit, that means meditation and awareness. If you don't have that, even if you are healthy, you can go in wrong direction. You can go into drugs or alcohol. And you have lots of wealth and success, you waste it in wrong way. So this is the priority. So we have to balance it. So spend least time for survival. Spend more time to take care of your body and nurture your mind, and still more time to nurture your soul. Okay. How do you nurture your soul? You have to work, you don't have time. Awareness is the key. So real yoga is awareness. Maintaining awareness, who I am. I'm a constant consciousness which watches all the changes so that you don't get attached. You don't get attached to your job. You don't get attached to your family. You don't get upset because people insult you. You don't get overexcited because people praise you. You maintain your energy. This is how you should balance. And there should be maturity that you do it on daily basis, not just for a little time. So people get so excited and they start yoga program or any program. They spend 2-3 hours at a time, and then after a couple of weeks, it is gone. It is a steady, sustained practice. For example, I have spinal surgery, and I'm back. Everything is fine, so I'm getting back into it. Nobody has to motivate me. Mm-hmm. It's always part of me. So make it undercurrent that this is what you want, so nobody has to push you. Come on, wake up or do this or do that. Here at condominium, they have a clubhouse. They put all the equipment, and they have swimming pool. In the summer, I'm the only one who goes regularly and do my laps. Only 3-4 people sometimes have signed up. I go there twice. I do treadmill, and I do bicycle, because just to build up, besides yoga. But stability, and I see some people come, sometimes they come, spend 2 hours at a time, then nothing. So this is what has to be digested. So another advice is, change, manage your mind rather than the body. Prepare it mentally. And I put several topics, I think, in one of these books that are essential for succeeding in anything. And see if I can find the page. Yeah, I wrote it in short, and books have detail, but these are the fine points. How do you integrate yoga in everyday life? First thing, clarity. Okay, just all this is on page 209 of The Secret of Bliss. First, you need clarity, what you want. People are not sure what they want. Just impulse, they do because of impulse. So clarity of what you want. Second thing is love what you do. If you love, you know, somebody's addicted to coffee. Nobody has to have, oh, morning come time, come on, take your tea or coffee. You love it, so you do it. So love, whatever you do, love it. Decision, people spend time in indecision, doing, not doing. Commitment, they're not committed. You know? I mean, so these are, the point can be elaborated. Priority, set the priority, because other things become important than I will do tomorrow. We procrastinate. Then urgency, you know, it's no urgency, you know. I have a long time to live. We are so much in illusion. Most of us are in illusion like we have 100 years to live. But look at it. We have only 10 years left, 15 years left, and no guarantee we will live tomorrow. Urgency. Intensity. Like you do it half-heartedly. Intensity. I learned tabla on my own, harmonium on my own, raga on my own. So how to find a teacher? Because that is that same principle I'm applying, and I'm finding joy in it. You know, creative energy. Then you cannot be stagnant. You get tired, bored. So you become creative, like doing workout. Become creative. So you find joy in it. You know. So creativity, enthusiasm, and that is a big point. People become enthusiastic and lose it. So satsang is enthusiasm, see? So you get new spark to start your journey. Patience and perseverance, everything is instant. You do it and reward comes. But here in spiritual practice, reward is subtle. In physical practice, you can bend forward, you can touch your toes, you can do, you can measure it. But spiritual practice is subtle. You are evolving spiritually. How would you know? It's a subtle thing. So you have need patience and perseverance, undercurrent, deep desire. This is what I want all the time. It is not the doing. And then surrender. After all, we have limited power. After we do everything, we surrender to higher power. So all our energy is, and intention is thrown in the space, and all the situations get attracted to our life. Does that make sense? But just for a general message for everyone, because this is a good question.